Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Pawan Kumar, and today I'll be explaining about the topics of microwave tubes. So before explaining about a microwave tube, let me see what are the different processing done on a particular signal. Generally, we know we have an amplification of a signal as well as oscillation of a signal produced by the electronic device. So what are the basic electronic devices, or what are the basic tubes which are used for the amplification as well as the oscillation of the particular signal are the conventional triodes or pentodes. And apart from the conventional tubes, we also have the basic electronic devices, that is a transistor and a FET. So these are the basic tubes and the basic devices which are used for signal amplification as well as oscillation of a signal produced in a general circuit. But why we are shifting on to microwave tubes instead of these particular tubes and the devices? So generally, when we see the frequency range of a microwave, the microwave frequency range goes from 1 GHz to 1000 GHz. The microwave frequency is from 1 GHz to 1000 GHz. So for this particular high range of frequency, there will be small limitations or errors obtained in the basic conventional tubes as well as the basic devices of electronics. So what are the basic limitations or what are the basic errors which is obtained when the frequency is increased? Let us see. Basic limitations which are being done. So before getting on to the each and every limitations, so why we are having a particular limitations when we are using the basic conventional triodes are, as we are consider an oscillator circuit where a signal is to be produced by using a external DC supply. So in an oscillator, we will use a DC supply signal to produce an AC signal. So for that, we will be having electronic devices as well as a tank parameters. So we generally say it as tank parameters, where the tank parameters are inductors as well as capacitors. So as the inductors as well as capacitors is depending upon the frequency ranges, so based on the change of the frequencies, the capacitor as well as the inductors will be varying. As the capacitors and the inductors are being varying, automatically it shows the decrease in the amplification or errors in the oscillation of the signal. So considering based on the tank parameters, we'll determine the certain limitations of the conventional tubes, that are inter electrode capacitance, and second is lead inductance. Lead inductance effect. Third is transition time effect. Transition time effect. And fourth one is inter-electrode capacitance, lead inductance effect, transition time effect. The fourth one is gain bandwidth limitations. Gain bandwidth limitations. Fifth, errors due to RF circuits. Errors due to RF. And the last is errors due to radiation losses. Errors due to radiation losses. These are the five different categories of limitations which is being obtained by the basic conventional tubes. So getting on to the first limitation, we are seeing it as inter-electrode capacitance. So as I have said before, depending upon the tank parameters variation, the signal amplification as the oscillation and the oscillation will be varied. So when we see the reactance of the inter-electrode capacitance, so we know that the reactance of the capacitance formula can be determined as Xc is equal to 1 by 2 pi Fc. So as I have said before, Xc is inversely proportional to the frequency. As you already know, when you are using microwaves, which is of a higher frequency range, automatically when the frequency of the particular reactance of the capacitance is increased, the Xc will be approximately equal to 0. So as you already know, when Xc is approximately equal to 0, it is considered as a short circuit. So this is one of the basic error which is being obtained when the frequency is being increased in a particular amplification as well as oscillation circuit. Now coming to the next limitation, we have lead inductance effect. So in the lead inductance effect, so similar to the reactance of capacitor, the reactance of the inductance can be calculated as XL is equal to 2 pi Fn, where we can say XL is directly proportional to the frequency. As XL is directly proportional to the frequency, when the frequency is increased, the reactance produced by the inductor is getting increased. So the input parameters or the input signal which is produced by a device is getting increased apart from the output parameters. So I mean to say, if you are considering an amplification circuit, the main operation is when an input signal is being given, the output signal has to be amplified with respect to the parameters. The voltage is to be amplified compared to the input signal, the output voltage has to be increased. But when the frequency is increased, as the inductance is being increased, automatically the input parameters are being increased compared to your output parameters. So that is one of the another disadvantage which is being obtained by the conventional tubes. And the third effect is a transition time effect. So here we will be calculating what is the time taken by an electron to travel from a cathode to the anode. As you already know, the basic formula of a time is determined as t is equal to distance by velocity. Right? So in a conventional tube, when an electron is generated at the cathode end, it has to move across the tube to the other end, which is being kept by an anode source. So in this process, the particular time taken by the electron or the time delay of the electron is being calculated in the transition time effect. So when you see in a static state of this particular tube, the voltage provided by this particular electron is E into V, where V is the external voltage supply which is used to generate electrons at the cathode. And coming to the dynamic state of an electron, that is equal to half m V naught square. Here the voltage provided or the voltage generated by the electron is calculated by the dynamic expression. So first is the static expression that is being generated by the DC source connected to a particular tube, and coming to the dynamic end, here the electrons which is moving from one end to the other end produces a certain voltage that is being calculated as half mv naught square. So in an equilibrium condition, both the voltages are same. So I am saying that under equilibrium, the static voltage provided as well as the dynamic voltage produced are equal. So EV is equal to half mV naught square. So from this, I can calculate the respective voltage of the electron as V naught is equal to 2 eV by m under. So this is the respective voltage of the electron which is traveling from a cathode end to the anode end in a particular conventional tube. So when you substitute the voltage formula in the transition time formula here, so finally the transition time can be given as V by V naught that is equal to 2 eV by V by under root 2 eV by M. So this is the total transition time which is taken for an electron to travel from a cathode end to the anode. So here, as the particular frequencies are being increased, we have a change in the external voltage as well as the mass of a particular electron. So as the frequency is increased, the tube, the voltage of the particular electron is getting increased. The tube which is being affiliated to amplify or to oscillate a particular signal will be affected. So that is our third main disadvantage, which is produced by a conventional tubes. And coming on to the another effect, the fourth effect is gain bandwidth limitations. So here, the main bandwidth calculation is been done using a resonance effect. So resonance. So in a particular circuit, the bandwidth of the particular signal is being calculated by a resonance. As you already know, the basic resonance circuit consists of a resistor, a capacitor, as well as an inductor. Right? So as you already discussed in the first point and second point, where we have a certain errors or certain limitations by the usage of capacitor and an inductor, automatically the gain produced by the bandwidth will also be reduced using a conventional tube. And finally, when you get on to the errors due to RF as well as your radiations. And finally we have two points, that is errors due to RF. So errors due to RF determines the errors produced by the skin parameters of the tubes. Means it provides the depth of the particular tube. The errors produced by the depth of the particular tube as well as the traveling of electrons in a particular tube will be determining the particular errors in the RF frequency. Next, when we discuss about errors due to radiation, errors due to radiation. So as you already know, when the frequency is increased, the wavelength gets decreased. As the wavelength is getting decreased, the conventional tube electrons will be scattered from its particular tube. So we can consider the tube of a conventional triode or a conventional pentode. As the wavelength of a particular signal is being decreased, as the frequency is getting increased, so the signal which has to be traveled across this tube may be having a chance to escape from this particular tube. So that is why, due to the decrease in the wavelength also, we are making sure that you construct a particular tube so that as we are increasing the frequency levels, the particular signal should be in a tube without scattering or without escaping from a particular tube. That is why, due to all these particular limitations, we are shifting on to a microwave tubes. So those basically coming to the basic so coming to the first microwave tube, where a particular amplification of a microwave frequency has to be done. So for example, we'll be considering a two cavity Mistron amplifier. two cavity klystron amplifier. So here